Well, at the moment, all I can take are some things that I don't really need. Alright, as suspected, we got some revolts to deal with down here, but that's okay. The cores will be rolling in soon. Ah, good, that's got Norway out of my face. As long as we just keep them positive. Still... oh, good, they won't join any coalitions there. England might, but, you know, to hell with England. Jake, you still have an uncored ex-Muscovite province. I can't core it just yet, that would be all it... oh! Revolts do strange things. To coring. I wish I could explain it, but I can't. Kind of frustrating that you're blockading probably the wrong province here. Yeah, no, you're not. Okay. Okay. So they're probably going to want to come into Simbirsk. That doesn't afford me any particular advantage. So let's go and take them on. 1-2 and 1-3. Yeah, let's take on the weaker one first. And boom. That helps us out in a multitude of ways. I also really need to stop slacking on my relations with Navarra so that I can gobble them and Estonia up before too long. Okay, so sitting on a comfortable 33% overextension, taking 42 is not going to rock the bank. Taking 46 won't either. Let's not get greedy here. Okay, Sweden joining a coalition is no problem. But having them not join a coalition is even less of a problem. That looks ugly as sin. But I'll accept it. But Stockholm needs to fall first. Hell no. Hell no. Don't often send for a trained medicus, but 8 years old to a 57-year-old ruler. Well, I guess that war with the Golden Horde's going to be starting shortly. Or Musk of Novgorod. Crap, so many targets, and I need to declare soon, or else it's up Poo Creek without a paddle for me. Right, Stockholm falls, we get the cores going. And we just jump into war with the Golden Horde, with the idea that it's going to be protracted. Should probably be doing it now, before my ruler dies. My ruler is also a general. Should do it now, but don't really want to fight horrific large forces. Even if they are technologically on par or inferior. I mean, I could cut back a little. Or a lot, I don't know. Why am I not declaring that war? It's surely gonna shoot me in the face when I don't, and my king dies. But these cores aren't ready yet, so I would have to defend them at all costs. Golden Horde gets advantages fighting on home planes. I also need to begin integration before... no, integration can wait. Let's do a quick province count then. We're at 73. 74, 5, 6, 7 if you take this into account. So 77. 78, 9, 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 88. So I only need 12 provinces more. That's alright, right? Jake, it's time to bite the bullet. Declare war on the Golden Horde. Can't argue with that, can I? Golden Horde and Crimea, huh? It's gonna cause me some issues. Crimea can field a fair chunk, and they will throw it right at my face. But the alternative is worse, to be fair. The alternative is a lot worse. Let's conquer Tambov. I'm going to feel so admonished if my king dies right about now. think we're gonna have to just kind of take it easy here for a wee bit. Looking at 30,000-odd, and I've only got 21k on the front lines here. Let's back it up a bit more. 22 supply limit there, which is fine. Come on, Stockholm. You're not that great. Alright, may as well strike them down whilst we have them taken away from the bunch. Oh, hello, Crimea. I see you mock me, good sir. You mock me good. Well, it's going to be a sloppy and horrible war anyway. Let's just bite the bullet. Jake, you've got rebels at... Oh, I've got rebels at a lot more than 80%. Harshly treating them would help out, but only by a little. I'm going to be eating rebels no matter what. And they've got their own Permian separatists now. Ah, oh, it's going to be like Sarig Yogir all over again. And we're hemorrhaging money. Oh well. And maybe I should get that tax from the Pope. Yeah, I'm not seeing much else to do with the Pope right now, so sure, give me that tax, my good friend. Cheers, big ears, now stay the hell out of my country. Sweden. You are Swede done. That's one down, but we still need Penza. Penza, which they are keen on ruining my day in. Alright, you guys get over to Samara. You guys deal with that. 10-1s. It is not what we'll get here, but oh well. A victory is a victory. Good lord, Stockholm, come on. Jake, do you have a truce with Novgorod? I do not, but calling them in would bring in Kiev, who's not a heavy hitter, but last we saw they had one hell of a general. Alright, Sweden, you caused me too much issue. And I'm taking my money for all that trouble you caused me. So Sweden, Muscovy, and England would all want to join a coalition, but I do not fear that. That's a good chunk of provinces. 52 over extension. And we have some good... we can't core it all, but we can core some of it. Let's also get rid of that, since it's giving us some undue rebel likelihood. Even the Karelians wish to rise up. They're going to rise up eventually anyway, so we're just going to have to bite the bullet on that one, but ho-hum. In any case, that's only 52 over extension for our existing 23. So goodbye, Sweden. Embrace the border gore. Core all we can. There'll be plenty of time for coring later. And that pops us up to 84 provinces. Good thing those Astrakhani rebels are still doing us some justice. Okay, excellent. Muscovy have pulled their finger out when it comes to fighting the Permian rebels. I hope. I really hope they don't stroll into here. Still hoping that. Alright, so now we've got all these provinces to worry about. Thankfully they are righteously Catholic, so we can just throw them their autonomy and they'll be more than happy. And it frees up these units to come on home. We can also pretty much stop paying for my heavies, since I'm not going to be fighting a naval power anytime soon. I also don't really care about this fort. Did I grab any other forts I don't care about? I'm also paying for all these forts that I certainly don't care about. If anything, I should hit the magical stop paying forts button and only care about... Well, there is the slight chance that Crimea could launch a naval invasion down here. But it is very slight. I do care about Olenets. Otherwise, though, oh, this one is useful. It's more than proven its worth. Let's grab Tambov since it's our claim. And we're also awaiting those Muscovite separatists. Has the Iberian wedding fire, Jake? It has not. But nor is the Burgundian inheritance. It's unlikely to, since... Ah, bollocks. Permians. Well, the Permians will probably be drawn back into Muscovite land, and they've already increased such and such there, so there's no real big problems to be had. Land and Finland. Finland, potentially, only because it's too expensive. Alright, we got Tambov. Oh my, we're not the only ones at it. Lithuania has decided to go on the offensive. They'll probably drown out their numbers slightly. We need to make sure we take Saratov then. Get our siege genius on the case. Oh dear. They're keen on defending Saratov. Let's just leave them to their own devices then and hope that Lithuania can, you know, deal with the situation at hand. Good. Very good. Jake, is Austria still angry? Austria is very happy, actually. I mean, they're still annoyed that I did that horrible thing to them, but they'll get over it. They always will. Still want to keep sweet with you, since I'm going to get you inside me soon enough. Okay, they are not taking any of my garbage. I am not fighting them in their own land, since they'll get a 25% shock bonus, all of them. Okay, good. That is an end to you folks. I can take you out, and Kargopol is safe in the loving bosom of Zone of Control. Go away, guys. Plenty of Lithuanians for you to kill. No good on Finland. That's you folks. In fact, you are drinking deep from my cup of manpower. Hopefully my enemies don't see that as a moment of weakness. I'll get you folks up there to help them out. And we'll get our mostly dead ones here in the center to regain them, their numbers. King is a general living on the edge. Damn right. He's a sucky general as well, but I thought it was worth a shot. It often is. Okay, so the enemy numbers are not dropping. Lithuania is destroying Crimea, though. Might help us get them out of the war. England no longer trucifying me, but there is the coalition to be concerned about. I need to keep Norway sweet, but they are sweet. Who else? Burgundy, don't care that much. Sweden are below the threshold. And Muscovy, oh, they hate my guts thoroughly, which is a good indication that they will not join the coalition against me. Okay, as soon as Crimea's fort falls, that should be us able to get Crimea out of the war, touch wood. Still, if I don't grab Saratov, I won't be getting diddly. Jake, use your lazy dip on the Pope. No, I want to keep my lazy dip as a quick fire, quick draw, if I need one on these other guys. Actually, I need to go for a quick water break. I will be back in just a moment. Thank you. Okay, back and in the flesh. Where was I? Ah, yes, Golden Horde. You contain delicious provinces for me, and I'll be having them. I should also consider sending someone off to deal with that. But it's not a pressing issue. What is a pressing issue is getting Crimea out of this war, since they field the bulk of the army here. It is so strange to have Crimea and Golden Horde allied, though. Not even historical rivals, that is bizarre. But what can you do? You can just kill and keep moving. You folks doing here? I thought I commanded you to help us out. They probably got blocked off by Novgorod in some way. Right, so let's grab our heavies and mothball them, since there's no real need. And if you're not mothballed, then I don't know what to do with you, so stay in Nyland. Jake, show the stats of that 2-star Burgundian general. Looking at 4-2-1, so for this time of a campaign, utterly terrible. Ah, damn, it's in my interest for Lithuania to win this. But they're not going to hold out long enough. Still, it is ravaging Crimea and making them more keen on the idea of peace. It's also getting rid of them, so Saratov could yet become ours. Let's make a cheeky little invasion, see what they think. Whilst the rest of you come on home in time for Christmas. And we detach one merc to take care of that, and then the merc can go away. To put it nicely. So Crimea did win their battle, but they lost their entire force there, because they were too exhausted by the end of that. What a tragedy. Leaving only the Golden Horde and the Shirvani force. What a joke. Joke with no punchline. Did help Crimea get their siege stats back. That's neither here nor there. Get you guys together, ditch you and Samara and the rest of you. Stay safe. You guys don't stay so safe. I want you to investigate, and if you find a Golden Horde, kill it. Yeah, sure enough, the Golden Horde get the bonus on Horde planes, but I'm not so concerned about that if I'm the attacker. It just means that they defend themselves a bit better. That is why if you're playing Horde, always seek to attack, never seek to defend. Alright, let's just kill the suckers. I need to grab this, or rather do a land grab, before Lithuania get their little clutches into things. 12 days until you're done. I want to arrive after those 12 days are up. 13, that's fine. So that's wonderful. Jake, in my recent campaign, Turkish Delight was eaten up by Karaman, Byzance, Trebizond, and Hungary. How very unfortunate for them. Okay, so even though I get a great shock roll here, I only do 75% of that damage. Well, I say only. They're gonna die anyway. Sucks to be them. So you take care of that. Might as well take care of the Crimea so he doesn't interrupt me. Even though Lithuania probably have that under control. Oh, they do. Oh, what a waste of time that was for me. And we even have all this discovered. So glorious. That's glorious. Jake, I thought the Golden Horde got bonuses both ways. If you are a Horde in plains, or farmlands, or drylands, or steppes, or anywhere that does not give a penalty. I'm not sure if coastline counts, come to think of it. Flatlands, no forests, no hills, and all that. If you are defending there, you will only take 75% shock damage. If you are attacking, you will deal extra shock damage. It's in your favor to deal the damage rather than defend. Because that's where your strength lies as a horde. Okay, you guys are surplus to requirements, so I want you to hold off the Krellians that may rise up here. We're pretty safe in the rest of the lands, lovely. I need to consider what I can be taking here. I want to grab, do a land grab, and hope not to disturb the peace too much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. No real point going for Saratov. What possible advantages there in doing that? That would perturb Crimea and Nagai. Perhaps I don't want to be too greedy here. Crimea we won't care about because we'll have a tonking big truce. Might as well grab some money to keep the war machine running. But we need Saratov to fall, and we need Crimea kicked out. Crimea are very, very close to being kicked out. Wonderful. Don't want to jump in on these guys, but we'll see what they're doing. Cores, Jake. Yes, cores are good. We want lots of them. Might as well loot a horde just for a laugh. Yeah, a few of these provinces fall, and so too will their desire to stay in this war. That's it. That'll be Crimea out. We have it. Got to grab a ducat or two. Okay, so that blitzes Crimea out of the war, gives us full reign on the Golden Horde. Not really interested in Crimean land though, so thanks for the money, good sir. I want my diplomat home faster than that, please. I wonder. It just seems like such a waste not to take more. Although Shirvan being involved is actually enough to slow it down there. Do I want to hang around for too long or not? There we go. Lovely. We don't have anywhere close to the admin to core this. And we are too close to overextension, so we might as well wait it out. So that means you wonderful folks. We've got 22 supply there. You are 12, 13, 14. This is plenty. We're good. And I said I'd kill you. There's also no real need to pay our guys for this. So let's save up a ducat or two. Isn't it grand? And as before, let's keep that improving relations. Now we're going to recall the Estonian one because we have sucked up to them enough. Let's suck up something else. We'll go for the Pope. Now Burgundy's still doing alright, so I guess we won't be able to do our dream of destroying Burgundy and Aragon. I fancy a little more chance in the papal game. Not much else to do with the papal influence, so we'll spend it on that and hope that Burgundy dies. Paulus and grand old age that he is. Ah, all is well. My question is, who do we kill next? We still have a few more provinces to take. Novgorod's sitting there all pretty with land that we need. We will begin the integration of Estonia as soon as possible. That's in 4 years. Like I said, that's 3 and 4 provinces when we count Novara as well. I think Novgorod's going to have to go. The allied Sweden now. You know what? Circassia's right there. We white-pieced them. Nobody cares about Circassia. And it's European land. Sure, it's increased coring cost, but... meh. Admin has barely been the choke point so far. Doubt that's going to start now. Jake, your king is still alive. Do you want to siege up Novgorod in the meanwhile? Maybe not call your vassals into war. Ugh, no. Bad time for warriors to discover that books exist. Yeah, that alliance with Sweden suddenly makes me a bit more hesitant. Just because it would be a hassle. I don't want a hassle. Livonian Order are almost friendless. But I don't have Cassus on them. Well, we'll deal with the Golden Horde and see what we've got, because I think our heir is almost of age anyway, and we need a bit of chill and chill time, as it is. There's also a fair chunk of European Nogai land. Well, maybe a fair chunk is pushing it, but there is some. And yeah, I think Circassia will serve as the backup land. It's all dirt poor. Nogai may claim to want it. Okay, the guy might be able to vassalize them, which would pose a problem. Nothing to worry about, except maybe the Sami. So let's pay our troops and wonder where he wants to rise up. Only Kola. Not here, for example. Only Kola, actually. We could do a thing about that before they even rise up. Potentially. Sweden, huh? Take Riga. You tempt me so. But Riga is extremely built up. And they are Prussian, so that would perturb Germany. To a degree that I don't want to do. Alright, glorious. Overextension is a thing of the past, so let's bring the future to our doorstep. But, and there's a big but involved here, we're going to wait for this because that should get rid of our Sami friends. Not that I fear the Sami. Why deal with a revolt that you can just completely bypass? Plus we need the time for admin anyway. We're going to be choking on 670 admin worth of coring, and we have only half of that, not even. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 more provinces to go with the 84 we have. Eh? You get out of my land, you hear? What are these guys playing at? Really, what are they playing at? Oh well, anything to weaken Burgundy, right? Right, the Sami are more or less gone. They'll be re-rising up anyway. So let's do it! Thanks for the land, my friend. Diplomatic power is now becoming an issue. So let's get ourselves someone that'll help us out there. How convenient, he'll help with diplomatic annexation as well. Speaking of diplo annexation, if I don't begin cutting some ties, we're going to have an issue or two integrating my vassals here. Oh, how convenient. Get strong. Seven out of four. Part of me feels that I should cut off the Pope, but having him as a friend is so useful. So nice to show that I'm a devout Catholic. So we got all these fellows here to help out with the revolts. No forts to worry about, not that it's really a worrying thing. But there is still the desire to kill you. 93, huh? We can pretty much take our pick of the land we want. And Circassia is right there, so let's just do it. Maiar, please. And we still gain 3. Yeah, Lithuania is Orthodox, but they had horrific rebel problems, so that's not too unexpected. Aggressive expansion is at an all-time low there as well. I kind of want to ditch them as an ally. Because there is no real thing I have to worry about anymore. There's no real coalition that's going to hit me. Do I only have an alliance with them? Lithuania, Military Access Alliance. Well. Sorry, but it was a boat for one. Jake, how many more provinces do you need? 7. And if you don't count my vassals, 3. So thanks for the ride, Lithuania. It was fun, but it had to come to an end. Frustratingly, you guys are still all chummy. I like the Pope, though. I'm gonna keep him on my side. Yeah, Kiev is doing not too shabby. Must be that staunch alliance they have with Wallachia keeping everyone in their place. I dare not attack Crimea on their own since they're allied with the Ottomans. The Ottomans have been underperforming, but, you know, they're still there. They even allowed Mamluks to sneak in and grab Adana. Why, what's up with Aragon? What have you done now? Still have your union, mind? But you're at war with Morocco and Tlemcen. Ah, Portugal must have been at this. Attacker against Morocco. Well, no problem there. It is probably just going to be a case of consume Circassia for those extra provinces. Jake, can you go fire the Burgundian inheritance of the last provinces? And even if I were to 100% them, I don't think the time would be on my side. It is chance-based, after all. Not something you can guarantee. Why do you want access? Do you want to slaughter what's left of the Golden Horde? Well, I will not let you. There's the slightest of chances that I might need the last of the Golden Horde provinces, if all else fails. I don't think it would fail, but... Never rely on the kindness of man, and always have a backup plan. Circassia is getting destroyed by Nogai. That's not a problem. The problem will be if Nogai vassalize Circassia. Nogai conquest of Circassia, so all they need is the capital, right? No, it's, No. No, I'm thinking of Horde versus Horde, Casus Belli. Alright, Circassia will be fine. The guy probably just want to chew off a few provinces. They're still busy on the capital themselves. Oh, Austria! We still have that thing going on, so sure. Let's be friends again. Forget that little matter with Burgundy ever happened. Adorable. I want to begin this annexation. We can get it started in about a year. It's gonna drain my dip. Not really much of a problem. Dip grows ever slowly, but it still grows. With that in mind, I might as well just fabricate another claim. We don't know if Kuma will be absorbed by the Nogai. Don't know how much will be, but they'll start absorbing soon since they've secured their only fort. Okay, this is not a problem at all, except for the fact that you're going straight for Olenets. So that's going to be something to deal with. You guys help them out. Oh, no, no, no. I can hit them first. That is excellent. Throw two shock in their face. Strange that there's not a single bit of cavalry on your team. But that means that you will not need further help. Which is good, because I'm sure the Golden Horde and Astrakhani rebels are going to be... And this is a strange thing. Sometimes you get a revolt and it just suddenly says, hey, you can core all this stuff now. And I say, great. Muscovy look awfully tasty, they say. But they are too big to guarantee. For me. Nice to have loads of money, let me tell you. My Nagai, you're doing terribly here. Although, King Devalois still on the go. Pretty average, but lasting as long as they need to, and not a moment too soon. So if you're thinking it's a bit anticlimactic, then, well, can't really refute that. Oh yeah, these guys. Who needs cavalry anyway? We've got enough infantry to flank. Excuse me. Circassia's doing too well here. It is tempting to pull the trigger on them already, since we could just march into the capital and... In fact, we only need a few provinces, but I also want to begin integration. That'll be in April. Let's just do it. When in doubt, just do it. Trebizond couldn't throw more than maybe 5 or 6k at us. Even though they've probably been developing 5 times. Nice job. Alright. Begin. Be done in 91, no problem. When it comes close to being done, we'll also begin the integration of Navarra, who unfortunately has also been improved a fair chunk, so they'll take a wee while. Take 104 for you, so we'll start you when we're halfway through Estonia. I love money and prestige. Give them both to me. Alright, let's do it. We've got nothing to worry about. Unless, of course, that goes a lot faster than expected, but... Eh. We'll be fine. Wait, what was that about, Theodoro? Oh, Trebizond got jumped as well. By Karakuyunlu, I believe. How unfortunate for them. What is unfortunate, though, is it looks like we were not the first here. Yeah, Nagai secured Circassia. But we can ensure that they don't take all the land. Which is the main concern here. Let's just ditch the bare minimum we need. And the rest of you, do a land grab. Sorted. Jake, can you describe the guarantee exploit? It's been fixed internally, so you won't be seeing it for much longer. But basically, you finish a war with somebody and you get a truce. Maybe the truce is 7 years, maybe it's 15 years. Oh my, that's a revolt. Good thing I was completely prepared for this. Take out the smaller ones first. So you have a truce, maybe it's 7 years, maybe it's 15. And you think, I don't want this truce. So you guarantee them, and then you revoke guarantee, which normally gives a 5-year truce. But it's a bit silly because that 5-year truce overwrites the old one. So it becomes 5 years. But their truce with you is still long. So that's a problem for them. So what you do is you use that to bypass them joining coalitions against you. Usually, that's the main use of it. Alright, I know we're throwing ourselves face first into positions where we have low morale, but it's better than allowing them to bunch up against us. Most things are. Just as planned. Wimpy rebels. Okay, there is seriously nothing to worry about anymore. And with Circassia destroyed, and the fact that we aren't even wanting much land from them, I mean, consider it. We're at 93. 94, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to take 4 for safety, just in case something horrible goes wrong with Navarra. And always grab more than you need, so we'll grab 5. Huh, more built up than I thought. I don't want this 10 development one, but the alternatives are insufficient. Actually, this is going to hurt my dip a fair chunk. Ah, well, what can you do? Take it all. I never checked the coalition's map mode, but I'm sure it'll be fine. Oh, and yeah, the moment we're halfway through with that, we'll begin with you. Nothing to it. And there's no revolts due up north, so we may as well bring you down here as well. What a horrific bit of border gore, but all in the spirit of Big Blue Blob achievement. Jake, are you still going to go for better than Napoleon? Yeah, I don't think I'm just going to do that in my free time. The more I think about it, the less I want to continue a run as France. It really has just solidified in my mind that the reason I like to play these kinds of games is not to play as an established power and continue growing and growing in a disgusting manner. The power is actually better in this case. We don't care about stability that much. But it's to take the pathetic underdogs and turn them into the grand powers that they always deserve to be. There's no joy in my heart for painting things as France. My next campaign will have to be as a tiny power to make up for this. Because it just ain't right in my head. Jake, keep in mind your dip rate changes as your overextension does. That's alright, because it changes for both of them. Should be done in September 91, should be done in June 91. No problem. No problem whatsoever. Right, the Astrakhanis wish to rise up next. That actually does not include these lands, it's more southern than that. There we go. Well, I guess that's kind of excellent news for any budding Big Blue Blobber, because it removes this area from the HRE, so if, say, I needed to do a land grab, I would do Provence and Savoy ASAP. Jake, next campaign, Romania achievement as Moldavia. I've already done the Romania achievement. I did that on my laptop, so that was not streamed. When in doubt, bribe someone. Yeah, I did Dracula's Revenge. I'm trying to remember how it even went. I think I just sucked up to Poland. And then Poland did everything for me. That was a while back now. Okay, probably won't let me do any of this until Manish gets cored. Bang. Oh, that's one thing I forgot. I forgot to raise the autonomy here. So these lads probably wish to rise up. Not by much, mind. Yeah, recent uprising. Well, we'll increase autonomy anyway because it's not like money is an issue. Jake, is there any achievement as Trebizond? Yeah, Trebizond has the achievement to become an empire. Wouldn't mind giving it a go sometime, because it would also allow me to use the decision for free westernization if I was so inclined. And I would be inclined. 98. Really, there's no reason not to just speed 5 and sit back. Welcome to the family, Estonia. I didn't mean to click that as fast as I did, since it drastically slows down the integration of our good little Navarra. Oh. He almost made it through the entire campaign, since he was the heir at the start. But he had to die about a year before it all comes together. We feel for him, we really do. All we need are these next cores. So yeah, this campaign kinda goes against everything. Lobby, ugly borders, playing as France, but we stuck to the main rules that I always have when, what? Venice and Mantua. Yeah, I think you'll be fine, but I'll help out, because why not? And this is where it all comes apart right now, suddenly. Coalition War, Muscovy, Ottomans, Castile. Yeah, not really. Jake, have you done a little purple nation next to Crimea? Yeah, I did a large campaign as Theodoro. Which was pretty cool. Bit blobby. Bit unexciting towards the end. Well, towards the start, let's be honest. But it was done. Actually, we're cutting it a little close to the grain here. Would be terrible if I'd lost a province or two and wasn't able to get it. Oh, it would be really horrible if what ended up happening was I'd grabbed some non-European land. Wouldn't that be awful? Well, we need only get the last of these cores. I think one of them is all we need anyway. Byzantine refugees, absolutely never. Non-overseas cores. That'll change once we get these ones on the go. It would be really exciting if somehow this messed up and I made some terrible miscalculation. But if that were to happen, I would blitz Provence. I wouldn't think twice about it. They hold provinces that are within my culture group, so they can be cored faster than normal. So, let's see. Yeah, I would have to take Anjou and Finisterre? And I would just do the quickest of land grabs there. We could get them cored faster than most. Actually, in the spirit of imagining that that might happen, let's get our troops back. This is the ugliest France, Jake. I agree. I ain't here to be pretty. I just want to be done playing as France, because it's not great. I can't look at this and be proud. Jake, would you consider starting a game as a blue nation and conquering all other blue nations? It would have to be a certain blue nation that is small and crap. Hungary. And people call me into all these wars I don't care about. Oh, I would care about it if it if I was at war with somebody that had cores on these places that I have yet to core. That would be a big problem. But it is not the case. So I certainly hope not. Didn't they rise up before? Well, that's fine. Put them back in their place. And maybe that uprising will allow me to core this somehow. Not that I have any idea how that works. Thanks, Muscovy. Don't know why Muscovy is thinking that throwing stacks of 2,000 at it is going to help out. But hey, more power to him. I'm sure he has an idea of what he's doing. And that was the end of Circassia. Alright, Savoy just became the easiest of pickings. I would consider them if I needed to do a... Oh! Well, there was a Savoy once. It's gone now. I think Europe ends at Shirvan. Yeah, the moment you hit Shirvan, it becomes Asia. This was important when I was doing the developer multiplayer, since I had moved my capital as Venice. Remember when revolts used to cancel coring process? Yeah, those were dark days, weren't they? And that should be it. It doesn't really pop up on screen, but I can check. Big blue blob, 100 European core provinces before 1500. I remember when Johan came to my desk and said, "Do you think that's possible, Jake?" And I said, "No problem." Well, there we go. Comfortably in time without really trying. Shout out to Wiz, who tried and failed to get this achievement. Maybe you'll get it someday. I guess France is too much for you. As for me, I need to stop and think up a campaign, a new campaign for Europa, something considerably more challenging than playing as France. I'm sure it'll come to me. If you have ideas, I always read them, even if I don't always respond, so throw them in a private message to me. Not on the Twitch chat though, I can't read all of that, mind. I'm going to take my stream down for a short while, and I'll be back up, probably with some Resident Evil, because... actually no, I owe it to Lucky to play that later. Whatever, I'll be back up later, and if nothing else, at 8 PM CEST, Central European Summer Time, going to be commentating the Terranigma speedrun race. That's going to be a blast. In any case, that's Big Blue Blob done and dusted. I'm going to get better than Napoleon privately, because it's not something worth streaming, not something worth even putting any effort into. So yeah, cheers folks, and I'll see you later.